is Jean Marie Ward for Buzzy Magazine. With me today is Catherine Kurtz, the author of the much-beloved Durini series, the Adept series, and many more. Welcome, Catherine. December will see the publication of The King's Durini, the third book in your fifth trilogy set in the 11 Kingdoms. Is this your final word on the series, or will there be more books set in those kingdoms?
There will be definitely more books. I haven't totally decided on the next one, but I think it's going to be about the killings of war in 1025 when so many people died.
Oh.
And as soon as I finish proofing this last book, I will be starting on that.
Oh, that's great. What can readers look forward to as you wrap up the Child Morgan trilogy?
This book takes us up to the time when Alaric is 14 and with the birth of Kelsey, and the king puts Kelsey in his arms, and it's right after the christening. So we have the whole future to look forward to from there.
Which gives us a lot of options for more stories. Your fans will be very happy to hear that. You've been involved in role-playing for a long time. Saga, the Swordsman and Sorcerers Guild of America, the SCA, a.k.a. the Society for Creative Anachronism. How did these activities influence your writing, or was it the other way around?
Well, Saga was never really a role-playing society. It was a society of authors who were writing in the sword and sorcery genre. But the Society for Creative Anachronism, the SCA, I was very heavily involved in for many years, and I loved it, and I learned a great deal from it, and I wrote ceremonies. I was a herald, and I held most of the offices in the SCA. Once, I was queen once, I was steward of the society, I was a laurel and a pelican, and that was great. I moved into Ireland, and there was not meant much SCA there. I think I went to three or four events while we lived there, but I still love it. I don't think I'd recognize it if I went back to my home kingdom in Southern California, but I still love the SCA.
You can never step in the same river twice.
No, you cannot.
But I imagine that living in Ireland was sort of like living out what you were playing at in SCA. I mean, you were at a castle.
Well, it was almost a castle. It was sort of like a cross between Castle Dracula and Toad Hall. It was really a great house, and we loved it to bits. What was sort of like acting out the SCA stuff was that we were involved in a number of chivalric organizations, and we got to wear insignia and capes and be in ceremonies, and involvement with my husband's clan MacMillan. When our new chief was inaugurated, I went back into the historical records and recreated an inaugural ceremony for him because they didn't have what had been used for the previous chief. And that will be used when the next chief is inaugurated, hopefully sometime in the distant future because our chief is very young.
Did these activities play into your writing, or was there any synergy between the two?
Somewhat. I know that when Deborah Turner Harris and I were working on the Adept series, I took her to a chivalric investiture so she could see what it was like in Edinburgh. Working on that series, we went to all the sites that we featured in the series. One or the other of us, and quite often both of us, would go there. And so in a way, there's an Adept Trail in Scotland of largely National Trust for Scotland properties that have gotten increased visitation because of the books, so that makes us proud.
That's good. It's always good to be a boost to tourism.
Absolutely.
Makes you feel like you did your job.
Absolutely.
But, with all this neat stuff, and, your books have such a flair for history, such a flavor of the period. How could could you bear to move from Toad Hall cum Castle Dracula back to the United States?
Well, we could see the handwriting on the wall. The economy was getting ready to go. And we decided we would rather be poor in America than poor in Ireland.
Yeah, I can see where that would be useful.
We sold our house and we bought a very nice historic property in Stanton, Virginia. And it's federal period. We would have preferred Gothic, but there aren't too many Gothic houses in that area. But there's a lot of history in Stanton. And we've got Blackfriars Theater, which is a reproduction of Shakespeare's first indoor theater. And a fine Shakespeare company there that performs year-round. And fine restaurants and a beautiful part of the country, so we're happy.
Virginia is a beautiful part of the country. Now that you're back here, can we look forward to any stories perhaps set in the United States?
I don't know. I had to move to another country to write my first American novel, which was Two Crowns in America. And I don't know. I have not been intrigued by American history as much, although Two Crowns, I enjoyed that very much. And
yes.
I might do something.
The door is open, in other words.
Oh, yes. Well, the door is always open for any good ideas.
Yeah. Speaking of good ideas, what are you working on now?
I'm finishing the proofing on this current book, which will be out on December 3rd. And I haven't started on the next book yet, although I know what I want to write.
Him? Or is that too spoilery?
Well, I haven't got it nailed down.
Okay, fair enough. Fair enough. Okay, the last question we always ask is anything you'd like to add? This is your chance to talk about something that's important to you. Anything?
Oh, gosh, I can't think of anything. I'm too busy trying to catch up with technology. I just got my first smartphone a couple months ago, and I'm still exploring its mysteries. I got a new computer in December, which has Windows 7 and Word 2010, and they're both different from what I was using before, and this version of Word is driving me crazy. I need to update my website. I'm beginning to feel very much like technology is leaving me behind, so I've got to do some serious catching up in the next few months.
Well, I'm sure you will. And the fans will follow you there.
Well, I hope so. I do have a chat every Sunday night at my website at raymondcastle.com. And if I'm in town, usually I show up at 7 o'clock and chat for an hour or so. And there's some great folks that show up there.
That's cool. Well, thank you very much, Catherine. And thank you. And thank you for Buzzy Magazine. Okay.